On the air with Dr. Robert Bukowski from Hartford Hospital. You're a surgical oncologist, is that correct?
Correct.
Yes, and we're getting ready for summer. It's coming up just about a week from now. A lot of us are going to be spending time in the sun, kids too. I mean, this week is coming up, the last day of school for Hartford, so a lot of kids are going to be heading out into the sun. We're talking about something that can be deadly serious, life or death, melanoma today. Can you tell us a little bit about who is at risk for this?
Well, everyone's at risk for melanoma. We usually see melanoma in the older age group, people who've been out in the sun for long periods of time, but we're seeing it now in a younger and a younger population. In fact, there are very few cancers that occur in children between the ages of 15 and 25, yet if you had to pick the most common one, it's really melanoma.
All right, so tell me what we should be looking for here. Good moles versus the ones that are deadly, very dangerous. How do you know the difference between those two without going to a doctor?
Well, we kind of look at the A, B, C, D, E's of melanoma. A looks at symmetry. If a mole is symmetrical, in other words, if you cut a mole in half and it looks the same on each half, then that's a benign mole. If you cut a mole in half and things look different, that could be a malignant mole. B stands for border. A benign mole has a nice, round border, smooth border. A malignant mole or a malignant melanoma often will have a very ratty or very irregular border. C is color. Color is very important. People who have a mole that is a continuous color, uniform color, that's benign. However, if you have a mole that has a red spot, a little darker spot in it, even a brown, black area, that could be a worrisome mole. Mm-hmm. And then D stands for diameter. And diameter, we always think that melanomas usually are at least 6 millimeters or the size of an eraser head. But we, in all honesty, can't see melanomas less than 6 millimeters. And probably the most important thing is what we call E for evolving melanoma. If you have a mole that's beginning to change, it's beginning to bleed, it's beginning to itch, then that's a mole that needs to be biopsied.
Yeah, you definitely got to check it out. And
Correct.
Your family can help you do this, right? Your spouse, somebody can help you look at these things.
That is very, very important. I think that one of the most important things is that we should know our bodies. We should follow our skin, look in areas like on our back and on our back of our neck. These are areas that we can't see. And we should rely on our spouses or friends to look on one's back, because that's where melanomas go undetected. And there's no question, if you pick up a melanoma early, the cure rate approaches 100%. Mm-hmm. If it goes neglected and it grows, then obviously the outcome isn't as favorable.
Right. Dr. Robert Bukowski from Hartford Hospital, thank you so much for coming in. Life-saving information. I hope you enjoy your summer.
Thank you for having
me. Thank you so much. All right, Scott, over to you.
He's my doctor. He checks me. 640. Don't go anywhere yet. I got to get your phone number again. 644. Early warning pinpoint Doppler is.